consider it a great privilege. My name is Ayooluwa Olasupo. I am. That will be anyways. My name. I just feel more at ease using it in literary.
Inspiration.
To get ingrained into the sphere of writing, because all of us here, we are all writers, but I feel that it's always at one point or the other that anybody really got into the core, or what we call in my field, into the intima of writing, I mean the innermost layer of writing. So, before I got into that last year, of course, like I also said in the interview, I had actually been writing when I was in primary school. Like almost every writer has that kind of story.
Lovely.
I was compiling. Okay. Started like I just have a passion for always wanting to see my handwriting in a new book. There was a special kind of. I mean, is it?
Enthusiasm.
Yeah, exactly. Like an enthusiasm, like something that gives me delight to just always want to write on any new book. And so I said to David, I was notorious for always wasting money buying exercises. Like that was mine. But for me, it was always giving me joy. So I'll buy a book once I used to have, like, I want to write it again, another new book, you know. It was first the passion for writing before I even got into the literary aspect. But I think around my primary four, I think I was around 8 or 9 then, I started to compile some stories. And then, okay, again, I think I also had a background that was just like the first reader said, a background that was fairly rich in the literary aspect. And that was, my dad was a scientist, he was in biochemistry, graduated from OAU. But my mom, at some point in her NCE, she did some literature. She actually studied English and literature. So my house was a combination of science and literature. So we had a shelf that has all the chemistry, physics, everything. But beside that same shelf, there also were nation car, all those Macbeth, Merchant of Venice, everything. But what I noticed growing up was that when I go to all those other Merchant of Venice, you know, all those books, I'm like, what's my mom reading about? What about all this?
Tell me, what are you saying?
Because yeah, speaking is nonsense. I really cannot make anything out of it. But my dad also being a scientist, he also has a rich literary background, but he has more crime and detective novels, and so those ones sound more on point. So it was a group of James Bond series, James Ali Chase, all those. I can't remember some names. There's even one big book. I've forgotten the name of the bookshop. So one after the other, you steal the books, or kind of, well, you just pick up the books. Sometimes in between the big textbooks, because you might not be able to find out that you are not reading your school books. So like that, I started reading James Ali Chase books. Very interesting, different series of his books, because they are crime and detective, and they used to be very, very interesting. Sometimes also I read Chinua Achebe's Things Fall Apart in GSS 2. Some other titles. But all those other ones that were true literary, all those were literary income.
True literary.
I don't understand the purpose why those books were written. But the ones that have a plot, that have a setting, climax, suspense, and you can enjoy it, I was cool with those ones.
I'm not asking to.
Okay, so then another thing that also helped me, like apart from that, my parents were also like, they were also like storytellers. So all those old times, that's why I put it in my book. I said I enjoy telling children in the neighborhood Twilight tales, because I also grew up with Twilight tales setting. When we're about to sleep in the night, then my dad would start story of Japati Roko, Okoyonibo, all those stories, and they're always interesting, like very interesting. It's so good at the thing, I don't know. While my mom also tells us stories, but our own stories, she will be forming the story as she sings it. So we don't actually know that it is automatic. So she goes, well, you just know that this story is not ending. You are enjoying it. What about the story? So she just, tomorrow we'll continue. I just finish up and so they went to everyone, they went to everyone. Oh, okay, that's the story. You understand? So that also was something that helped to her. So when I was in primary 4, I put up all the stories that my mom always told me. Because because I know she formed them. So it's in a way they are like original stories. So I started now converting them, adding my own piece, and I was through with something that looked like a first draft of a story or stories. Some of them that I had, some of them that were originally formed by me, by her, my hair, everything. And it was a cool one. If I remember, the title of one that I wrote was No Condition is Permanent. Because we had to submit something like a competition, writing competition, and that was my mom just gave me a skeletal background of a story. So I developed it for months, and it became a very nice, a book that had, but somehow I could not print the book because of some things. So that was my own first exposure, and going to junior secondary school, I just realized I love English language. You know, sometimes some things are natural, and you are not even aware, but people call your attention. So sometimes you write essays in school for exam, for letters, and then the teacher is like, who wrote this thing? They are like, what did I write? So, like that began with me in GSS2, you know. My English teacher in GSS2 had to call my parents at the time that I have to be an art student, that I have to be an ambassador of Nigeria to French, all those things. My interest was in science. So that also happened in my senior secondary. I remember I wrote a story in essays, more like the letter to your brother, telling him of how you spent the other day. And we had like 8 or 9 branches, you know, those public secondary schools. So I went to school of science, West College in Bali. So I wrote the letter, and while we were planning to finish the year, I think she just walked into the class and she was looking for who wrote the letter. But the class I was then was like the notorious class of bad guys. So she just assumed that it cannot be that class. So she went to all other branches. When she could not find the person, so she was reluctant to eventually come and picked up my letter. Like, I didn't really understand what was special about letter because I don't know. So somehow I started now discovering that it seems this writing thing. So sometimes I join my seniors to go for competitions that are like writing. I remember one Martina B spelling competition, all these writing things. So that was my background for writing. But immediately I entered university. Okay, when I finished secondary school, I started writing a drama. And it was also a nice one, but somehow, I don't know where the book is. You know, all those stories that all of us used to have, like, you just write something, that premise put one, so I don't know where it was. So the only thing was I just got admission and I just misplaced that book. I think I wrote up to like 60 pages of that drama book. I just didn't know where I misplaced it. But immediately I entered school, medical school for that matter. Oh. Somehow, you know, by normal automatic realigning, I did not really remember anything about writing. But though the passion is always there, I still write a lot, maybe for church, for here and there, and all of that. So I started, but I was not conscious of writing as a field on its own that I could have explored during my school days. So like, you also have something similar. I remember, okay, maybe we have a speech, maybe one of my lecturers, maybe there's a program, and they need somebody to write a speech that somebody can read, and they need somebody to hijack, to, you know, it's medicine. So you normally not find people that are into writing. So they're always surprised that, okay, we are having this association of doctors, something, the president's speech, can you help us? Okay, I can help you. So that was our, so that was my own contract, so not the love point thing, but I also did the contract.
But we met at the point, we both stole books,
and still went to them to school to borrow our friends, who did not return, you know, those bad things. So during my, because we really spent a lot of time in the medical school, with strike, so spending almost 10 years in school and all that, it just did not really occur to me that I could have, I explored other things, I learned other things, but it did not occur to me that I could have tried to get into the, I was not aware about the field of writing, like what is going on there, I did not, but when there is something to do, during my final year, one of my consultants, he's a psychiatrist, he runs an NGO for mental health, and he needed people to be updating his blog. So it was those kind of times that, I will help. My final year, a friend of mine was the best graduate student myself. He needed to read valedictorian speech on the graduating day. I wrote it for her. You know, all those kind of things. So throughout my school days, I really did not understand that there was a world of writers. But I think somewhere, there's a brother of mine that introduced me to poetry in 2016. So I would say maybe I started writing poetry in 2016. But not poetry like that. You know what I mean? Like what's our status poetry? Just yeah, this thing look like poem, put it there. Let everybody know that. People don't know I think that I said they were just rubbish, nonsense. But at least that was when I started writing. But it was until last year. Last year during the COVID break. broke out things from some of us. So during the COVID break, I don't know, you know, because during the COVID break, the literary world, they really made you soft.
Yes, yes.
It brought out the literary world so, I mean, so massively that here and there...
We were all forced to write.
Yes, then there were people who made use of that time to create competitions, this and that. I saw this professor, Rabo, Reata, this one, Poetry Prize, this one. I was not really interested, but some of, because of those jargon that I used to put on my WhatsApp status, thank God for them. For the past 4 years, I would just write something that looks like repetition, that looks like line. So people really thought, or maybe they were correct, but I was not really a real poet. But at least people now began to send all those poets. Yeah, I'm a man for poetry. So they will send it to me. So that was how somebody sent. I think two, there was one by Pamela Ajayi, the woman that owns Fat Care. She's a poet. She does this, what's the name of this very popular, I forgot the name.
I know. Okay,
Splendors of Dawn poetry. Very popular platform on Instagram. So it's just about climate preservation. She's a consultant pathologist, but she's into climate, all these things. So they normally do yearly poetry. So somebody sent that, and I started preparing for it, so I could not submit. Another person. So that was where, in a bit to submit for those competitions, I had to now get a little bit more serious. All those my mom's textbooks that I felt they were not good to go here. Now they are okay. So I started stealing some of them from home, getting them to school, starting to read them. So I can just say it was last year. And there was a competition that I also did. That was my first competition. And it was also something that also opened. Though it had both stages. The competition had both stages. But the first stage, I think God just wanted to encourage me that you can do this thing. Because the first stage were 50 writers. And somehow, I just found out that I came first in the first stage. Even though I could not meet up in the last stage, I was top six, not part of the top five. But the first stage, I was the first. So it was like what he was saying the other time, that when you find that encouragement, it was like, wow, okay, that means I can really do this thing. Another thing that helped was connection to some people, like prominent writers. Some of my friends, some of my seniors that graduated from the medical school, somehow I think they caught love with writing too along the line, and they were already doing well, winning prizes here and there internationally. So I could just reach out to one of them. I want to be like taking this thing serious. So I think one of the things that helped me, even though it's not like I've developed my heart so much because I don't have so much time to do all this reading thing, and I don't totally believe that, because writing is a talent. But in terms of career, it looks like you are co-closing because I'm a medical doctor. So I really don't have that time. But one thing that has helped me is connection to quite a number of people that I met on platforms, communities, and some of them are doing very, very well. So somehow, they are the push. But personally, I cannot really say that I've done so much with writing. I took a poetry workshop last year. I'm on quite a number of WhatsApp platforms. Then my first published work was last year for one Christian anthology like that. From there, I was able to write for some African writing. And I think it was this year that I got my first acceptance for an international platform like that. So I think gradually, that's the I don't know if I'm saying what I'm supposed to say.
Yes.
Okay, so then this year I just got encouraged that if I just look at my passion for young people, because like sometimes about acceptances and rejections. So during that COVID break, after that competition, I now got more interested in poetry writing, like the core of it. So I took some poetry workshops online that were taken by some people that, well, I did not know them before that time, but according to the people who know them, that they are top people. I did some paid classes, maybe like 4 or 5 classes. Some were free, some were paid only. So that made me to just still know more about people. So my first published work, that was when I already mentioned. And there were times of rejections, of course. And so thank God that those poetry workshops already prepared our mind about. In fact, the person that took one of the classes that I now linked up with him is the editor-in-chief of one African writer, this Shallow Tales Review. His name is Chief Muyeka or something like that. He's an Igbo guy like that. So he is as prominent as he was when he came for the program. Okay, his name is Chidiebube Onyeka or something. So when he came for the program, he was like, he has had 30 rejections this year. And that was as at April. My. So I was like, are these the people that are coming to take us classes? That people say they are international and they are doing perfectly with their own presence, and this is his 30th rejection. Oh, fine. So I made up my mind that I think by the time I write 200 points, I can't get an assessment. So I use that kind of mind to, like, it helped me to ace more for excellence. Like, that means this thing must be very, very. So somehow, it did two things. It made me to have a kind of anticipation coping mechanism that, let me just, if I accept, if I'm accepted, if I'm not accepted, no problem. And at the same time, it also made me to ace for more exams. Like, before I can write something, you too, look at it very well, send it to people, let them check, so that you know just be writing. So I think, so far, those are some of the things. Then I think this year around March, or was it, okay, around May this year, I just started getting the motivation, especially for seeing young people who have stories to tell, but they do not really know how to tell their stories. Like, for me, that's a passion, because okay, there's a program I normally do like once in 3 weeks, although I don't have a website, but there's a program I do, it's like a creative program. If you have anything to present, maybe like a drama, a speech, word poetry. So I saw that people really, so I did it on Facebook and Instagram with an organization that I belong to. People really submitted their articles. So I was the one to sit down and make sure that those articles are fit before being posted on Facebook. But I noticed a lot of people really have raw talents. Like very raw. I have raw too, but you know, raw can still be different from raw. Like very raw. Somebody has a very nice story to tell about. Especially, you know, it can be painful when somebody has a story to tell of challenges, and such an article is rejected. I say, oh my pain, you are still rejecting my article. Like you don't understand. I'm going in deep into my personal life to share something painful that maybe I've come out of it. And you are now sending me a rejection. That means you are not only rejecting me, you are rejecting all my experience. I don't know if you get that kind of thing. So people, you know, people submitted articles of maybe when they've been through challenges and all of that, but they were too raw. They needed to be made into stories that can be presentable, that have beauty. So I was the one that now had to do that. Of course, like I didn't remember to do that. I also edit articles, like apart from poetry, like editing. So I had to sit down and I started editing all those works. And I will now send it back to them on WhatsApp. Come and see the joy, like the elation of like, is this my article? Of course, you don't want to over edit it so that it will not look unoriginal. But at the same time, it's made many people to be encouraged that, okay, so my story, I thought I should just hide my story. So my story can reach the world if it can come in a more presentable. And one of the testimony I got from that was there's a lady that also submitted, she was one of my sisters. I just, you know, helped her edit her quotable quotes, her essays, and somehow she just, I would like, she propelled from that stage, and today she has a writing hub of herself. So that began to be a motivation, like, okay, can we find people that have stories? Instead of necessarily rejecting articles, can we refurbish articles? Can we like ghostwrite or help to edit? Can we encourage people? And so that was what led to the creation of, because I'm curating, or should I say, I'm a founder of a particular ongoing literary magazine. Presently, so I started that this May. The deadline has closed, we are just compiling the articles. Of course, some of the articles too, some of them were really, I'm a novice too, don't get me confused. But I mean novice in parentheses, so novice list. So I was like, wow. So I think my own passion is just for young people, especially people who have stories to say, but do not have the right rapping sheets to rap their stories. So my passion is to help such people to get their stories out, edit their works, and let all of us have a good time. So books, about book reading, about reading of poetry, I cannot really, like I said, because of my time. So I read, one of the things that helps me is that I have website addresses for many writing platforms, magazines, online journals. So when some of them are even via emails, all poetry, international. So when they just publish something, I just read, I scroll, I continue seeing my patients, I read, I scroll. It might not be the real devotion. Sometimes it pains me, like, and this thing is my talent in secondary school, but this medicine will not allow me the full time to bring it up. But I'm not really in a rush. I'm writing for pleasure. I'm writing to fulfill the purpose of influencing lives. So, in a way, because people have, like, what's happening? We are not really moving. What happened? Well, I know I'm growing. But not really at that pace that is like, because I've been a bit different from it. So it's a privilege to be here again. I don't know if I, so about reading poetry, I cannot really say I've read so much. I think I like contemporary like these our days, the lives of all the people that are doing well. I cannot begin to mention the Romeo, Reguen, Logan, February, Jide Badmo, so many other people that I know that yes, they are not the Wolishon Incas, because I don't know, I really don't really enjoy. They have aesthetics. I had to learn some things from them when I was learning the basics of poetry. Me, Yoshundari, is it this man from Kenya, Tiong, something? All of them. I mean, I made sure so that. Yes, that's the man. So I read J.P. Clark. At least I tried, but I don't really fall so much in love with those old styles like what I'm seeing contemporary writers doing these days. So I read more contemporary writers. So if I mention it, you might not really know them except for those of them that are notable.